Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me an enormous pleasure to welcome you all here this evening for the 2017 Monkstown Art Exhibition Lunch. An enormous amount of work has taken place to prepare for tonight's festivities, and I think it's fair to say the results of all the labours are very clear to see. Now, the French artist Matisse once said that art is something to do with the achievement of stillness in the midst of chaos. And I have to say that I wonder as to his state of mind if he had ever spent a day trying to arrange a collection of paintings and artworks from 35 different artists, trying to fit them into an old Edwardian parochial hall in a village resounding to the noise of roadworks. Could Matisse have envisaged our chaotic minds here trying to match themes and frame designs? Could he have advised us on light levels, dark panelling, as opposed to white display boards? How would he evaluate whether unicorns would blend seamlessly with autumnal leaves, whether Bratislava, Wicklow and Connemara would blend together with Salt Hill, Annstown and Sandy Cove? What would he have advised about tractors, shopping baskets and fireplaces? Or what would he have wondered about the origins of Rudy, Lucas, not to mention a galactic explosion? I suspect Matisse, like us, who have journeyed with these artworks over the past few days, would have come to see them as old friends, appreciating with us as a committee the late evening light last night coming through the east window here in the hall, and how the stillness brought smiles of appreciation to our very weary faces. But all of these artworks radiate a story of the artists themselves, but also through the created by the creator. There is a stillness that shines through the creativity, and as the eye wanders around this old hall, it will rest on that which speaks to you, the viewer, and perhaps through that work, your eye will glimpse at the very inspiration which led the artist to express what is depicted. I have never believed that there is such a thing as good art or bad art. A collection of art such as this will appeal to each one of us in a different way. And I think the important thing is simply to let what is displayed speak and call to us. And it's through this speaking and calling we will sense the stillness, and that which calls us to stillness is what for us is meant to be. An art exhibition is chaos and stillness in equal measure. Earlier this week, I had the immense pleasure of wandering through our own National Gallery through the Vermeer exhibition. And despite the chaos of the crowds, there was a genuine sense of something wonderful and extraordinary. Today, we treat Vermeer as some sort of colossus in the art world, rightly so. But behind this extraordinary man and his incredible artistic achievements, there is a wonderful sense of the ordinary in his works. A parrot, a dog, a mystery unfolding through a letter, a maid with a knowing smile. Why do maids always have knowing smiles? A gentleman visitor, a reflection in a mirror, a terrestrial globe, abandoned slippers, beauty and tragedy through an open window or candlelight, all calling to us, inviting a response, and in the chaos of the moment, that ever sense of beauty and stillness. Tonight, as we gather here in very good spirits, let us be thankful for artistic endeavour and creative achievement. And in some way, let Carol Cullen challenge us to imagine who might be sitting beside her darkened fireplace. Let Sue McHugh's depiction of an old rectory interior help us to wonder as to past occupants. And maybe even let Olivia Bartlett's geese make us smile as we wonder which one has just honked. Perhaps it is Camilla Fanning's etching of the old tractor which reminds us of childhood spent in the countryside, or Nuala Walsh's lemons and Anne Tynan's Lanzarote which remind us of longer sunny days and sunnier climes. But all of these artworks have a story to tell, and our challenge is to discover the stillness and the joy which best calls to us. I simply use this opportunity to thank all of our artists for displaying their works again with us this year, and to thank most sincerely Sue, Liz and Colette for all their hard work, and to George Stevens, the National Maritime Museum, Jeff and Searson's Wine Merchants, I hope he's still here, and Chris and his staff in Café de Journelle for all their help and their continued support and that wonderful village spirit which we all share together. I also want to thank Leo, who festooned the Knox Hall exterior with bunting, and Grania, of course, for her wonderful flower arrangements. But finally, I thank you all for coming and supporting this event, the proceeds of which will be devoted to another parish cultural dream, the purchase of a baby grand piano for the church. So it gives me great pleasure to officially and formally open the Monkstown Village 2017.